Welcome everyone, I hope you're having a fantastic day. This video is going to cover my experience with the Xbox Elite Controller Series 2 in the first 24 hours of owning this controller. The next video that comes up on my channel, probably in 2 days' time, will be my Xbox Elite Controller Series 2 setup video for Modern Warfare. I'll also cover the Series 1 controller in that video as well. I want to take just a little bit more time to get that video finalized. I've actually got the settings that I'm using and that I'm really happy with. I've got those set in my mind, but I just want a little bit more time to just give them a bit more trial in Modern Warfare. The reason for that is that the connections weren't particularly good for me today in Modern Warfare, and the game itself gives us so much to learn. It's quite a bit different from our usual Call of Duty, so I want to make sure I've got the setup absolutely perfect, or the best that can be, at least in my opinion. I'm 99% sure I've got my finalized setup, but I'm going to give it like another day's play and then get the video edited and up to give you the settings that I think work best with the Elite Controller in Modern Warfare. So for this video, I'm going to talk about my experiences with the controller in the first 24 hours, and I'm showing you some Modern Warfare gameplay. I wanted to make this video because the next one that comes up about the actual setup of the controller for Modern Warfare, I really want that to focus on the controller itself, the settings in the Xbox Accessories app, and the settings in Modern Warfare. I won't be showing much gameplay in that video. I really want it to be very much to the point about the settings. So I thought some of you would like to hear my thoughts in the first 24 hours and also see some Modern Warfare gameplay of me using this controller. So what do I think? What are my experiences so far? Well, it's been quite a good 24 hours since I've bought the controller, and of course I have been sleeping, but the times that I've been playing the game, I've put in quite a few hours using this controller, really going through all the different thumbstick combinations, the different settings in the app and so on, and the different settings in Modern Warfare. And that's how I've decided to test out the controller, with a view to getting my setup video ready. And I have to say, I'm quite happy with my purchase. It's a really good controller. There is so much to learn about this controller. The original Series 1 controller obviously gave us lots of options, but this one now adds a few further things that I need to consider for doing any setup videos. The main one is of course related to the thumbsticks, both the new choice of thumbsticks that come with the controller and the adjustable tension. I'm preferring the thumbsticks that come with this model over the ones that came with the first controller, the Series 1 model. There are subtle differences between some of these thumbsticks in terms of height and just how they feel and how it influences your gameplay. Obviously there's one taller thumbstick and you can clearly see it's taller, but even for the more standard length ones there are some subtle differences. So it takes quite a bit of experimenting and testing to get the ones that you like and to get the controller performing its best in the game. Then of course we have the adjustable thumbstick tension. This is something I've been experimenting with quite a lot, and I'll probably cover the full details of that more in a review video in the future, but let's say it definitely makes a difference. It definitely changes how the controller feels, and it definitely influences your performance and your feeling and so on in the game. So there are three adjustable tension levels. We've got the loosest tension, which is probably similar to the standard Series 1 Xbox Elite controller. Then at the most tension, it's more like the original Xbox 360 controller, and then we've got sort of a new level which is almost midway between the two. And I'll cover it in my Modern Warfare setup video, the one I'm using for the game, but I've pretty much got that finalized, but it definitely took quite a lot of testing. I do think different people will prefer different tensions. It really depends on your preferences in a controller. Microsoft themselves believed in their research that the loosest setting which came on the standard Xbox controllers and the original Elite controller, they believed that that was the best performance, and there were some benefits from having quite a loose tension. But I always wanted to, if I could have changed anything with the controller, I would have liked to be able to just get the stick tension increased a bit. Going back to the Xbox 360, the sticks were much more tense in that one, more tension, more resistance to movement. But as I say, in their research for the Xbox One, Microsoft decided and did some testing to show that looser sticks would offer benefits to most people. It's great now to have the choice, and it's probably something that people may originally settle on a certain tension, but over time they may adjust, and it's certainly something you may want to adjust from game to game. Each game obviously feels a little bit different. The developers set up the controls to feel different, so it's certainly something to experiment. But regarding Modern Warfare, I've found what works best for me in combination of stick tension and also the actual choice of sticks as well. So I'll cover that in my setup video, which, as I said, will come in the next couple of days after this video goes up. Then on the back of the controller, we of course have the new paddles. If you do have an original Series 1 controller, or you can get the paddles, they actually work on this controller. That's something that I thought was the case, and a few people have actually confirmed that. The new paddles are smaller, and they require a bit more tension to actually activate. Now, that's not down to the actual paddles themselves, but more the contacts that they're pressing on the back of the controller. In my opinion, I didn't have a major issue with the first Series 1 controller and its paddles in the back. They were sensitive, but I never really pressed them by accident unless it was when I put the controller down. They were quite large, they didn't require much pressure to activate, and if you put them down in the wrong place, they could get activated. On this one, that's not really the case, and the paddles work fine for me. I do understand that some people may prefer the larger paddles. However, after using this controller for a while, they fit in the perfect position for me. I've maybe adjusted my grip ever so slightly from what it was in the Series 1 controller, but I have absolutely no issues with the paddles on these. They perform nice positive feedback when you click them, and I've managed to get the hands on the controller in a very comfortable position, and I've got my fingers resting on the four paddles on the back. But as I say, depending on your own hands and so on, some people may prefer the larger paddles that came with the Series 1, but it's nice to know they can be used as well. The actual trigger themselves have got a new level of trigger stop, so it's actually crazy how little they can move. I think it's something like 3 millimeters, and you can be aiming down sight and firing in Call of Duty very, very quickly indeed. Also, quite a nice touch I like on the controller is that there's quite a subtle texture just where your fingers would wrap around the triggers, and it actually offers quite a nice little bit of resistance. I think the original triggers, it wasn't really an issue to me, it's not like your fingers going to slip off them, but they offered no resistance, so there is a nice bit of texture in these, and you do notice it, then you forget about it. So it does its job without being noticeable. It does offer some resistance and keeps your fingers exactly on the triggers in the position that you want. Other than that, the controller seems well built. I like the new grip feature, which goes over the top as well. I think they've changed the material to try and alleviate the complaints with the first model. Some people had issues with that. It never was in my particular Elite controller, but there was a few people who had issue with the grip coming off. So time will tell, but it feels nice at the moment, and hopefully there will be no issues with that as the months pass and the controller gets many more hours of use. And that's my first impressions. I'm glad I've bought it. I do really enjoy using it, and I think it has the potential to improve your gameplay if you're someone that knows what you're doing and has got the time and is willing to really experiment and try different tension settings, try different thumbsticks and so on, and get the controller set up so it feels really natural in your hands and that you can aim and move around well in Call of Duty or whatever other games that you like to play. But so far, impressions are positive. I definitely feel it's made a slight difference, a slight improvement to my aim in Modern Warfare. But I have to say, it's quite a difficult game to test out. I think there are some issues with that game at the moment. You can't move around too much or you're going to get shot. So it's not like testing a controller in any of the past few Call of Duties. But that is something I'll be doing over time as well. I'll be giving the controller a try in those. But for the moment, my attention is most definitely fixed in Modern Warfare, getting that setup video done. And I've really been enjoying using the controller in the game. So that's it for this video. That's my first thoughts over 24 hours of owning the controller. I've used it for quite a few hours and it's been performing well. As I say, there's been a few connection issues in Modern Warfare itself, but other than that, I'm really pleased with the controller. If you're someone that likes to switch around thumbsticks, configure software and so on, it really is a dream. It gives you so many customizable options, you really can perfect it to your own taste. And I'll be going into more of that in coming videos. But for now, thanks as always for watching. I do appreciate it, and I'll see you soon for that Modern Warfare Xbox Elite Controller setup video.